Welcome to this demonstration of OnePlaceDocs, a product within the OnePlace solution suite for providing enriched document management on the SharePoint and Office 365 platform. In this demonstration, you will see how easy it is to save documents from Microsoft Office, Adobe Acrobat, and Windows Explorer, and conveniently access locations in SharePoint you really care about. Firstly, we'll connect to our SharePoint environment. You can connect to one or more site collections or sites across your SharePoint on-premise and Office 365 environments. Once connected, we'll add some favorite locations. These favorite locations are shared across the OnePlace Solutions suite of products. My favorite SharePoint and Office 365 locations are now available when saving from Office, Adobe Acrobat, and Windows Explorer. They will also be available in Outlook if you're using OnePlace Mail. Before we save content to SharePoint, let's take a quick tour of the SharePoint Docs Explorer. This is a Windows task tray application, meaning it's always ready and available for quick access to SharePoint locations and content you really care about. On the left-hand side, you will see the navigation tree with the favorite locations we've just added. This navigation tree is used across the OnePlace Solutions suite of products. This means the same favorite locations, recent locations, SharePoint connections, and solution profiles provided through the OnePlace Live service are available when saving documents from Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and also from Adobe Acrobat and Windows Explorer. If I select a location such as the document library, all folders are made available. This has been tested in extremely large folder hierarchies and libraries with a large amount of content. Document sets appear in a similar manner. If you have access, you can create new folders or document sets without the need to navigate back to SharePoint. On selecting a location such as the document library, the available SharePoint views are presented, allowing you to filter, group by, and sort content as defined in SharePoint. On selecting a document, a preview is provided using the SharePoint server-side preview technology. If this is not available in your environment, or you select a file such as an email message not supported by the current SharePoint preview technology, we will still present a preview and retain a consistent user experience. To locate a document, you can filter content in the view, or use the power of SharePoint to search both metadata and content. Items are returned with appropriate hit highlighting of the search term. The Docs Explorer ribbon makes it easy to perform common activities such as viewing item properties and copying as link. Opening a document is as simple as performing a double click. At times though, you may also like to open a document in a different application. In this case, you can use the open with. For example, I could open a picture in Microsoft Paint or any other preferred graphics application. Even if your application is not SharePoint aware, you can make edits and simply save back into SharePoint. As you can see in the preview, the changes have been saved in SharePoint. At any time, you can launch the web browser to the current SharePoint location. This is a quick way to get to any SharePoint location in the web browser. Let's now open a document in Microsoft Word. I have an attachment in an email I received called Contract Version 2 DocX. I can open this in Microsoft Word. Now I'll make some changes in this document and select Save to SharePoint. This presents the same navigation tree and folder locations I've seen previously in the Save to SharePoint window. I can complete the metadata, or I can have a look at the existing content in the location and copy metadata, or in this case, I might replace an existing document in SharePoint. The document in SharePoint is called Project Contract DocX, but the email attachment sent to me was renamed for the sender to be Project Contract V2 signed. This is quite a common scenario. I will select Replace, and this will rename the attachment I'm saving to be the same as a SharePoint document. I also have the option to copy the current metadata. I'll make a minor adjustment and select Save. This same process of saving from Microsoft Word also works in Microsoft Excel and PowerPoint. Let's have a look at the results in Docs Explorer. I'll select the Contracts folder, and here you can see the documents we have just saved. I can view the item properties and version history to see the minor changes I've just made. Often we are sent PDF files or create PDF files in Adobe Acrobat. Using OnePlaceDocs, you can save from Adobe Acrobat or Acrobat Reader into SharePoint and complete metadata. In this PDF document, I can select File Save Copy to SharePoint. The familiar Save to SharePoint window appears, allowing me to complete any required metadata and save the document into SharePoint or Office 365. Upon saving the document, the PDF file is reopened in Adobe Acrobat. Saving files from Windows Explorer to SharePoint whether it be your local drive or a network drive, is as simple as selecting one or more files and performing a right-click Send to SharePoint. In this case, I will select a picture library, complete any metadata, and even associate the picture to an event. I will create a new event called Microsoft Ignite. Upon saving the pictures to the picture library, the items are automatically checked in. Again, I can take a look in Docs Explorer to see the results. I'll open this location in SharePoint, where you can see the pictures and the new event we created for Microsoft Ignite 2015. OnePlaceDocs enriches document management on the SharePoint and Office 365 platform, resulting in greater end-user engagement and solution adoption. It takes less than 3 minutes to download OnePlaceDocs, install, and get started. Thank you for taking the time to learn more about OnePlaceDocs.